Hi, welcome to Taro Movies. It can kill you easily and not even under winter conditions like today. Hypothermia. So in this video, I like to talk about what's happened to us if we are hypothermic, how do we lose body heat, and how can we protect ourselves from hypothermia. Thanks for joining me. First of all, we should start with some basics about hypothermia. If our core temperature goes beneath 37 to 34 degrees Celsius, our muscles begin to tremble. And this is an uncontrollable reflex to protect us from the cold and produce heat against it. The blood flow through our extremities is reduced, and the blood is concentrated in the core of our body and in our head to keep the most important functions going. We can feel that when our feet and hands are getting cold and start to hurt. Also, the mobility of our fingers disagrees. For an example, if you are not able to put your thumb and your little finger together like this, then that's a sign that you have to do something against this. At this stage, the body temperature drops quite slowly, but then much faster. And this is the only time frame where you can get out of the situation without help from others. What we can do is a lot. Maybe we have a warm drink, eat something. Then you should try to stimulate the blood flow through your extremities. Just get out of the situation, light a campfire, or just go into a warm room, wear some gloves, all stuff you can do. But first of all, we should know how our body is losing heat. And there are three ways of it. Heat conduction, convection, and thermal radiation. Heat conduction. The heat always flows from a warmer body into a colder one until both have the same temperature. That's why we need a very good insulation to the ground, so we can use a sleeping mat or some twigs or leaves to build something up. For an example, if I would stay here on this tree, my body heat flows into this tree until we have both the same temperature. And believe me, that's not 37 degrees. Let's go to convection. Convection is the heat exchange through a current, like an airflow or an air current if you move around. That's why we feel colder under windy conditions than the real temperature, and we call it wind chill. Good clothing can protect us here. And by building an emergency shelter, you should make sure that it protects us very well from the wind. Thermal radiation. A warm body gives off a part of its heat as electromagnetic radiation. Our neck area is very well supplied with blood, but has only a small layer of fat, so it gives off a lot of heat. That's why we should pay a special attention to this area. Also, good clothing can protect us here, or a reflector, like here, where I use a space blanket to keep my body warm. And we also lose heat while we are breathing, so don't try too hard. Then you breathe too deep, the hot air will cool your body down. A face mask or a scarf can help you a little. You should also avoid sweating too much. Wet clothes cool you down very, very quickly, which is why you should always take a change of clothes with you. And that's why I carry mostly in winter some spare socks, underwear, and a long sleeve shirt or fleece with me. Always make sure that you react to the early signs of hypothermia. Otherwise, if you are unable to keep or raise your body temperature again and it drops down between 34 to 27 degrees Celsius, you will become disoriented and your body gets in a stage of exhaustion until it becomes unconscious. The heartbeat gets irregular and you cannot get out of the situation without help from others. Death occurs around and below 27 degrees Celsius because the body does not longer breathe and the circulation stops. I really hope that you never get in a situation like this, and if that you are prepared and do the right decisions. For more videos, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and give me a thumb up. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Tschüss, ciao und bye bye.